Hello. In this video, we're going to show you how to use Postgres, specifically a next-generation managed version of Postgres on Google Cloud called AlloyDB for your vector embedding and machine learning database use cases. What's impressive about this architecture is that our embeddings can take full advantage of the mature and feature-rich capabilities of Postgres. Additionally, we'll enjoy a well-managed, high-performance experience in the underlying managed database system. If we take a look at the homepage for AlloyDB, it claims to offer 4 times faster transactional workloads and up to 100 times faster analytical queries compared to standard Postgres. This makes it a highly effective general database solution, and with a high level of convenience, since many engineers are already quite familiar with Postgres. To demonstrate the use of this database, we're going to develop a Python script and use the Vertex AI Embedding APIs for generating example vectors. As always, we'll post all code along with this diagram file in the video's description so you can follow along easily. First, let's set up our AlloyDB instance after enabling the necessary APIs. We'll create a cluster and an AlloyDB instance. We won't need a read pool for this demonstration, so we'll continue ahead. Remember to save your Postgres password in a safe location. Our instance is compatible with Postgres 14. We also need to enable private services, and an automatically allocated range should be adequate for now. For this demonstration, a small machine type should suffice, and we won't need any flags. When the instance is up and running, you can inspect the details and begin using it. For convenience, we'll use the Cloud Shell Editor, which offers a nice IDE environment for exploring the AlloyDB instance, and we'll run associated Postgres processes from this environment. To query our database, we'll run a project called Pgweb, which offers a nice graphical user interface for navigating Postgres. Through the Cloud Shell, we can utilize the web preview port to visualize the Pgweb application. Please note that you can also run this on your own laptop, so long as you have the network connectivity to establish an instance connection. Trying the standard connection will unsurprisingly get a timeout. We can't access internal VPC resources from outside of the VPC. So we'll tweak our approach and create a Compute Engine instance that will serve as an SSH jump box for accessing our new Postgres database. We'll create an SSH key in the Cloud Shell IDE and place the public key in the manually generated SSH key specification during VM creation. The provisioning should run quickly, following which we should have the external IP for our connection ready. In the SSH section, we'll adopt a similar setup as we did for AlloyDB, inputting our IP, username, and password with the database field left blank, then supplying our VM instance connection specifics. Upon successful entry, we'll notice that no tables are yet present, though there are a few pre-existing views. Let's attempt to create a database and see how that pans out. Brilliant! We've successfully connected to our demo database and can now move forward with executing queries. Up next, we'll try to set up an extension, creating it if it doesn't already exist. Post extension setup, it's time to put our new functionalities to the test by creating a table for some demo embeddings. Our example will utilize the Vertex AI Text Embedding API to generate these embeddings, along with an integer ID. You can gather more detailed information about this embedding API from the Vertex AI Model Garden in the Embeddings for Text section, which provides links to documentation and specifics about the API. If everything has been executed correctly, we should now have a functional table. It is devoid of data, but we'll address this shortly. For now, let's swing back to our Cloud Shell editor and build a script to generate example embeddings. Before diving into scripting, remember we're using the API mentioned above, which requires activation. To do so, head on to the Vertex AI dashboard and enable the suggested APIs. The script we're crafting is simple. It's using the Text Embedding API, and in concert with the complementary Python SDK, it simplifies the creation of text embeddings for a few example phrases. We'll insert these phrase embeddings into our embeddings table. Do keep in mind, to access the internal IPs for AlloyDB, we require a conduit such as a jump box or client. Directly running the script isn't feasible, but don't worry, you can download this script and use the same jump box as before, which should perfectly meet our requirements. With that said, let's utilize the in-browser SSH here. Once inside the box, we'll confirm a few prerequisite installations, pip if required, and the libpqdev library for Postgres. Our Python script will also need a Postgres library and a Google Cloud library for Vertex AI. Now, after the installations are done, navigate to the top right to upload the previously downloaded script and let it roll. Bear in mind for production scenarios that this Python code can be adapted to a wide spectrum of applications, services, and pipelines. Let's take a step back from the Python code and check out our accomplishment in the Pgweb preview, where, as visualized, the embeddings are present. Now for some fun with these embeddings. Remember that in the query editor, we have three distinct strings, each paired with IDs that align with the order in our Python script. Time to run a vector similarity search to see whether New York City dinner or paella dinner conceptually correspond more closely with Argentinian steakhouse dinner. To perform this, we'll fashion a query. The target is to access the latest embedding from our table and employ cosine distance to measure the similarity of all the embedding rows. No time like the present, let's jump right into it. In this query, we're looking for the top two results. If we limit the results to just one, we find that the ID returned is two because the distance between the third embedding and itself is zero. Indeed, that validation checks out, we do get the number two returned. Now let's increase the limit to two to see what the next closest match is. From that query, ID one is revealed as the next closest. Interestingly, our text embedding API seems to suggest that conceptually, or semantically, the Argentinian steakhouse dinner is more akin to the sunset paella dinner as opposed to the candlelit dinner in New York City. Feel free to experiment with some of the other options available in the pgvector system. For instance, you can swap cosine distance with Euclidean distance by merely changing the symbol. We could also consider including the text itself, or maybe a reference to some sort of file on Google Cloud Storage in our table. This could provide a more direct representation of the raw data in our embedding table. As a part of our ongoing AI series, we're continuing our AI safety donation program. If you found this video helpful, consider supporting the channel by subscribing. For every 10 new subscribers from this video, we'll donate $1 to support crucial AI safety research. As always, all the code used in the diagram from this video will be provided in the description for your convenience. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and we'll do our best to answer. Again, thank you for watching and please enjoy responsibly. Thank you.